Hello and welcome to our letter of the day video. Today's letter is letter W. W looks like this. Take a good look so you can recognize it. Here's another idea for you. You can decorate the letter W. We're going to be using some watercolors to decorate W. When you decorate the letter, it just helps you to remember what it looks like. So let's paint our W with some watercolors. Maybe we'll use some purple. And let's finish it off with some blue. Well, there you have it. We painted our W with watercolors. Now that we know what letter W looks like, let's try to write it, okay? So to write the letter W, it's kind of like making two letter Vs. Let me show you. We're going to start at the top. We're going to slide down and walk back up, slide down and walk back up. That's the uppercase letter W. I'll show you with my finger. Down and up and down and up. All right, let's try to write that on the handwriting house, okay? You can practice your letter W too. If you don't have paper, just skywrite like this. Okay, so on the handwriting house, this is an uppercase or big letter. So we're gonna start at the top. We're gonna go down to the bottom and back up and down and up. Slide down and walk back up. Slide down and walk back up. Down and up and down and up. Try not to pick your pencil up. Keep going all the way until you're finished, until you get to the end. Down and up and down and up. How about if I write one more to give you a chance to try to practice? Okay, so now let's see if we can write the lowercase W. The lowercase W looks just like the uppercase W. It's just a little bit smaller. So we're still going to go down and up and down and up. That's the lowercase W. On the handwriting house, it's going to be downstairs. So let's try to write that together. Down and up and down and up. Just going to be downstairs, but it looks just the same as the uppercase W. Down and up and down and up. Now that we know how to write the letter W, let's talk about the sound W makes. Well, W is for whistle. And when you whistle, you make your lips kind of pucker like this. Can you try to do that? Can you pucker your lips? Well, that's what you have to do to make the letter W sound too. You kind of pucker your lips and then you open them wide like this. Wah, wah, wah. Can you make that W sound? Wah, wah, wah. W says wah, wah, wah. Well, for our game today, to just help that sound to stick, we're going to be playing wake up. But instead of an alarm clock waking us up, I'm going to blow my whistle. So let's pretend to go to sleep. And when you hear the whistle, wake up, wake up. Are you ready? Go to sleep. Good night. Wake up, wake up, wake up. Let's do it again. You want to? All right, so let's go to sleep. Good night. Wake up, wake up, wake up. What does letter W say? W, 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 as in wake up, wake up. Let's play it one more time. Let's go to sleep. Oh, good night. Wake up, wake up. What does W say? Wuh, 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 as in wake up. Well, that's your clue today when we do our blending. I'm going to do this wuh to remind you that W says wuh, as in wake up. Before we do our blending, I need to know what the vowels are. Can you help me remember the vowels? Good job. The vowels are A, E, I, O, U. These are the vowels. Okay, we're going to put a letter W with each of these, and we're going to blend the two sounds together. That's how you learn to read. You just learn how to blend those sounds together. W, ah, wah, wah. Sounds like we're babies crying. Wah, wah. Let's try the next one. Let's put W with E. W, eh, wah, wah. Let's put W with I. W, I, wh, wh. Let's put W with O. W, ah, wah, wah. And let's put W with U. W, wah, wah. Well, let's try to read two words together today. I want this to say wag. So what letter says g, 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 g? It's the letter G. Letter G says g. So let's try to read this. Wag. 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 Like a dog that wags its tail. I want this one to say wet. So what letter says t, 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 like a ticking clock? That is letter T. So let's try to read this together, okay? Wet. 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 You did a great job. You read wag and wet. Well, in our story today, there is a dog, and dogs like to wag their tails. The story is about a little boy, and he has a dog named Willie. He wants to learn how to whistle. Willie and whistle both start with letter W. Since there's a little dog in the story today, I thought we would do some math activity that has a little dog, like the one in the story named Willie. This is also going to be a word problem. Now, a word problem is not like a real problem, like, what am I going to do? A word problem is just when there's something you have to figure out. So let's listen and see if we can figure out what the answer to this word problem is. There were five dogs by the doghouse. Two of the dogs ran away. How many dogs are left? One, two, three. Good job. Three are left. Do you see how to do the word problem? We're also going to be doing takeaway or subtraction, just up to five. So let's look at those five dogs again. There are five dogs by the doghouse. Three ran away. How many dogs are left? One, two. Good job. Let's try this one. There are five dogs by the doghouse. Four dogs ran away. How many dogs are left? One dog is left. How about this one? This time there are four dogs by the doghouse. One of the dogs ran away. How many are left? One, two, three dogs are left. There are three dogs by the doghouse. One dog ran away. How many dogs are left? Two. Let's get five dogs by the doghouse again. And this time, three ran away. How many are left? Two. Now there are three dogs by the doghouse. Two of the dogs ran away. How many are left? One dog. Let's do one last math word problem. There were five dogs by the doghouse. Five dogs ran away. How many are left? No dogs, zero dogs are left. Well, today in the story, there is a little boy and he wants to whistle. I brought a whistle today to show you. If you look really closely, you'll see something inside the whistle rolling around. Do you see that? It's a little ball. Do you know what shape a ball is? It's a 3D shape. It kind of looks like a circle, but it's not flat like a circle. It's round and I can hold it or I can roll it around. That means it's a 3D shape. And this is called a sphere. A ball is called a sphere. Can you say sphere? This little ball inside this whistle is a sphere. If you look really closely, you can see the sphere moving when I blow it. Did you see that sphere moving? So this is the shape of a sphere. It's down right inside of the whistle and it gives it that unique shape. That's our shape for today. Now, I already mentioned some things about the story, but I didn't tell you but that the little boy named Peter lives in a big city where there are big, tall buildings. Maybe some of you live in the big city with big, tall buildings. So today for art, we're going to be making a cityscape. Let me show you. A cityscape is just showing a city skyline. We're going to start by just making a sidewalk. I just cut some black paper and I'm going to glue that to the bottom. And then I cut lots of rectangles. I'm going to put the link below where I got this great idea. You can fix the rectangles however you want to on your paper. These are the big tall buildings in the city. I think I'll move this one right here. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Next, I'm going to do something fun. I'm going to add some newspaper that I cut into small squares like this. These are going to be the windows. I'm just fixing them on top. This is a really fun project for little hands. You'll get lots of practice with some little pieces of newspaper that you can fix wherever you want to be the windows on your cityscape. We're also recycling by using the newspaper. Okay, I think I'm finished. There's one other thing though that I want to add. I want to add this dog. This is like the dog in the story. He was a dog just like this. You'll see that. We're gonna read it next. I'm going to put him in the front. He looks really big, but the dog in the story isn't a giant dog. No. He's just a regular dog. The reason that he looks big is because he is in the foreground. He's close to you. The cityscape, or all the buildings in the back, are far away. This is the background. So they're far away. They look smaller. And the dog is near you, so in the foreground, and that's why he looks much bigger. All right, now let's do some science together. Well, for science today, we're going to make a wacky whistle. All you need is a straw, and you need to get a grown-up to help you to cut into the straw, but not all the way through. You want to be able to bend it like this. Next, you're going to put the straw into a glass of water. Now I'm going to see if you can listen and hear the sound that I'm going to make when I blow into this straw. It's going to be a whistling sound, but it's not loud like this whistle. It's kind of a soft whistle, but the sound is going to change. Let me let you listen. Did you hear that? Did you hear the sound? It kind of changed. Well, sound is just air that vibrates, or sound vibrates on the air, and there's some air inside the straw. The vibrations in the straw make the sound that you heard. The lower I put the straw into the water, the less air there is inside the straw. So the lower the sound will be. It'll be a lower pitched sound like this when you go down low. The higher I move the straw in the cup, there's more air inside the straw. So the vibrations will be more. They'll be higher. So there'll be a much higher pitch like this, a higher pitch. So low, high. Those are all due to the vibrations of the air inside the straw. Let me let you hear it one more time. I hope you can make a wacky whistle today. Before we say goodbye, I have a story, and that story is called Whistle for Willie, and it's by Ezra Jack Keats. Whistle for Willie. Oh, how Peter wished he could whistle. He saw a boy playing with his dog. Whenever the dog whistled, the boy ran. Whenever the boy whistled, the dog ran straight to him. Peter tried and tried to whistle, but he couldn't. So instead, he began to turn himself around and around and around. He whirled faster and faster. When he stopped, everything turned down and up and down and around and around. Peter saw his dog Willie coming. Quick as a wink, he hid in an empty carton lying on the sidewalk. Wouldn't it be funny if I whistled? Peter thought. Willie would stop and look all around to see who it was. Peter tried again to whistle, but still he couldn't. So Willie just walked on. Peter got out of the carton and started home. On the way, he took some colored chalks out of his pocket and drew a long, long line right up to his door. He stood there and tried to whistle again. He blew till his cheeks were tired, but nothing happened. He went into his house and put on his father's old hat to make himself feel more grown up. He looked into the mirror to practice whistling. Still no whistle. When his mother saw what he was doing, Peter pretended he was his father. He said, "I've come home early today, dear. Is Peter here?" His mother answered, "Why, no, he's outside with Willie." "Well, I'll go out and look for them," said Peter. First, he walked along a crack in the sidewalk. Then he tried to run away from his shadow. He jumped off his shadow, but when he landed, they were together again. He came to the corner where the carton was, and who should he see but Willie? Peter scrambled under the carton. He blew and he blew and he blew, and suddenly, out came a real whistle. Willie stopped and looked around to see who it was. "It's me," Peter shouted and stood up. Willie raced straight to him. Peter ran home to show his father and mother what he could do. They loved Peter's whistling, and so did Willie. Peter's mother asked him and Willie to go on an errand to the grocery store. He whistled all the way there, and he whistled all the way home. The end. Well, I hope you had fun today learning about W and whistles. Maybe you can make a wacky whistle in a cityscape or paint W with watercolor. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.